You've been asleep the past 8 hours. You haven't had a thing to eat since last night, and you wake up and your blood sugar's sky high. Don't worry, you're not alone. Elevated morning blood sugar levels are a common issue for diabetics of all types. Type 1, type 2, even pre-diabetics can face this issue. And today, we're going to go over some reasons why this happens, and more importantly, some effective proven strategies to get your morning blood sugar levels back in check. And make sure to stay with me till the end because the last tip is something you'd never expect. So first things first, why does this happen? Why do we wake up with elevated blood sugar levels when we've been fasting for the past 8 to 10 hours? Unless dreaming about carbs can cause elevated blood sugar levels, something's not right here. Well, it turns out there's several factors that can contribute to elevated blood sugar levels in the morning. Some of these are more obvious causes that many of us are aware of, such as your diet, medications, or your activity level. However, there's a lesser known cause that many diabetics struggle with, a sneaky culprit known as dawn phenomenon. Dawn phenomenon is a natural process that happens to the body overnight. Hormones like cortisol and growth hormone are released to get you ready for the morning and give your body the energy it needs. But for a diabetic, these hormones can cause your blood sugar levels to skyrocket because they not only increase insulin resistance, but they also cause the liver to dump a bunch of sugar into the bloodstream. The good news is there's ways you can fight back, not only against dawn phenomenon, but all of the factors that contribute to elevated blood sugar levels in the morning. And I assume that's why you're here with me today watching this video. So let's not waste any more time and go ahead and get started with the first tip, and that is some dinner time hacks. So how can you hack your dinner to get better morning blood sugar levels? You're probably already aware that making the wrong choices for dinner can have a negative impact on your overnight as well as your morning blood sugar levels. But the dinner time hack that I'm providing you with in this video isn't about what you eat for dinner, but when you eat dinner. Many people don't realize, but the time you eat dinner can have just as big an impact on your glucose levels as what you eat for dinner. In fact, a study from 2021 compared the glucose levels of two groups of patients. One group ate dinner at 6 p.m., the other group ate dinner at 9 p.m. Both groups consumed the same food for dinner, and the result was that the group that ate dinner earlier not only had lower morning glucose levels, but lower glucose levels throughout the entire day. So eating an earlier dinner can be the first step in improving your morning glucose levels. Of course, make sure to choose healthy, low-carb options for dinner to ensure normal morning glucose levels. Lean proteins like chicken or fish go a long way at not only keeping you full and satisfied throughout the night, but also prevent spikes in blood sugar. Veggies are another important part of the meal that will help fill you up without affecting your blood sugar. Also, make sure to incorporate healthy fats such as olive oil, nuts, and seeds. Most importantly, the carbohydrates consumed with dinner should be complex carbohydrates like lentils, brown rice, quinoa. These types of carbs are digested more slowly by the body, which can help to prevent spikes in blood sugar. Tip number 4, optimize your late night snacks. So late night snacking is something that many of us struggle with. I know I certainly do. And while late night snacking should be kept to a minimum to keep your blood sugar level stable, if you do find yourself in need of a snack before bed, it's important to make healthy choices. And I got some supercharged healthy snack options for you that won't spike your blood sugar, including one with a unique blood sugar lowering ingredient. So if you do need a snack before bedtime, make sure the snack is low in carbohydrates, high in protein and healthy fats. Some good options are a handful of nuts, low-fat cheese, a hard-boiled egg, carrots or celery sticks with hummus, and then we have Greek yogurt. So Greek yogurt is not only low in carbs and high in protein, but certain Greek yogurts that have added probiotics have an additional benefit that many people aren't aware of. Multiple studies have found that the probiotics in yogurt actually have a modest effect on blood sugar lowering. So if you do decide to snack before bedtime, make sure to choose one of these low-carb, high-protein snacks to keep your glucose levels stable overnight and within normal range in the morning. If you have any good diabetic-friendly snack suggestions, please share them in the comments below. I'm always on the lookout for some new creative snack ideas. Number 3. Exercise. So the blood sugar lowering potential of exercise is very often underestimated, but exercise can be a secret weapon against elevated morning blood sugar levels, and in some cases may be just as powerful as some prescription medications. So as we discussed earlier, overnight you have a surge of hormones causing insulin resistance and extra sugar from the liver. The good news is, exercise effectively targets both of these factors. Regular exercise can cause the muscles to soak up that extra glucose from the liver, as well as decreasing insulin resistance in the body. And regardless of the time you choose to exercise, you'll not only see an improvement in your morning glucose levels, but also in your glucose levels throughout the entire day. This is because the blood sugar lowering effects of exercise last for up to 24 hours in some cases. To get the most benefit from exercise, aim for at least 30 minutes of moderate intensity exercise at least 5 times per week. Brisk walking, cycling, or swimming are all good options. And remember, even a small amount of exercise can make a big impact. So don't feel discouraged if you can only fit in a few minutes of activity at a time. Every little bit counts and will help to improve your morning glucose levels. Tip 2, optimizing your medication regimen. Another big culprit for elevated morning glucose levels is a non-optimized medication regimen. For instance, if you're taking basal insulin like Lantus, Tresiba, Levemir, or Toujeo, and your glucose levels are in normal range before bedtime, but you're waking up with an elevated glucose level, you'll likely need an increase in your basal insulin dose. A good way to optimize your basal dose is to increase your basal insulin by 2 to 4 units every 3 days until your morning glucose levels are at target. Another factor to consider with basal insulin is the timing. Different types of basal insulin can peak at different times. So in addition to adjusting the dose of basal insulin, sometimes the timing of the insulin needs to be adjusted as well. Some diabetics may need to take their basal insulin in the morning, others may need to take it at night. It's also important to consider that many diabetic patients are more insulin resistant in the morning. Depending on the type of medication you're taking, you may require a higher dose of insulin or an adjustment in your oral medications to keep your glucose levels from spiking in the morning. If you suspect that your medication regimen may be causing elevated morning glucose levels, it's important to discuss this with your endocrinologist or primary care physician. It's also important to remember that your medication regimen is not a one-size-fits-all approach. What works for one person may not work for another. So be patient, work closely with your healthcare team, monitor your glucose levels to find the best medication regimen for you. All right, so this last tip is definitely a surprising one. So tip number 1 is vinegar before bedtime. That's right, a shot of vinegar before bedtime may be the key to improving your morning glucose levels. This is one I wouldn't believe myself if there wasn't numerous studies to confirm it. Even a study by the American Diabetes Association showed vinegar ingestion at bedtime can improve morning glucose levels. This study had one group of participants ingest 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar before bedtime. The other group of participants did not. The participants that consumed the apple cider vinegar before bedtime had a 4-6% reduction in their morning glucose levels compared to the placebo group. While it's been suggested that vinegar may reduce carbohydrate digestion and delay gastric emptying, the researchers from this study believe the main benefit is by disrupting the cycle of glucose coming from the liver. Once again, another way to target dawn phenomenon and improve your morning glucose levels. Well, I hope that was helpful. If you have any tips or tricks you use yourself to improve your morning glucose levels, please share them in the comments below. If you're enjoying the content, please consider subscribing, and thank you as always for watching the video.